Sarah. I represent a Greek archaeological site in Naples called Ipogeode Kristallini. And so in cases where cities become primary tourist destinations and face the imminent threat of mass tourism, the community involvement might be the only remedy to counteract the extreme excessive commercialization of both tangible and intangible heritage. However, especially in economically disadvantaged cities or neighborhood, the inclination to prioritize financial gains over the protection of their invaluable intangible heritage might be prevalent. So my question is, how can we effectively communicate the critical imperative of protecting intangible heritage to communities, and what measures do you suggest to concretely and comprehensively involve local communities in urban context and make them feel like a real part of decision-making processes in heritage sites? Thank you.
Maybe Dr. Mounir, you have an inter.
So I want to intervene on this topic because it is one of the urgent topic which is facing at the same time the preservation of sites, the preservation of cultural landscape, but also the discussion about the development of tourism. And I think we have a very good operation here in Italy, in Pestum, where every year we have this La Borsa del Mediterraneo per Archeologia e Turismo. This encounter, which is organized every November each year, is touching a site which was inscribed in 1998, not only an archaeological site, as Pestum is an archaeological site, but also all the environment around the site of Pestum, Valdidiano, Certosa di Padula, Velia, and we have seen all along the year how there is this interpenetration between those who are in charge of the management of the site as an archaeological site and museum, but also the Valdidiano, where we have seen all the values of the intangible heritage of the site.
No, stesso facendo il taglio.
Of course, in Italy we have so many examples of archaeological sites where there is over tourism, and Pompeii is very close to here, and we know that there is a very great effort about management of tourism towards archaeological sites. And I am an archaeologist, and I was faced with this kind of situation because people, when they are invited by the tour operators, they want to see only some of the aspects of the archaeological sites, and maybe later I will show one of the examples in Southeast Asia, in Cambodia, with the site of Angkor. So this is a question that again can be discussed between the tour operators and the managers of the sites.